Welcome back to the Air of Authority. My name is Andrea, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about why your furnace will turn on and then almost immediately shut off, also called short cycling. So I'm going to call my dad right now, and he's going to tell us what to do if that is happening at your house. I have a new joke for you. The other day, I got in an argument with my furnace, and things got really heated. I don't know why I love dad jokes so much, but they just make me so happy. An annoying problem that people have sometimes is, why does their furnace start and then just immediately stop?
Cycling on and off, what we call short cycling, it sounds like it's coming from the ignition portion of it. So there'd be two questions. It could be one of two things. One would be, am I hearing the actual burner lighting and shutting off? Do I see it light and shut off and short cycle? If that's the case, there's a problem in the flame guard circuit of the furnace, meaning it's not sensing a proper flame. Something's not right. Probably a thorough cleaning is what's in order there. So if you're hearing the inducer assembly, which is a little combustion blower on the furnace, if you're hearing that short cycle on and off, the issue is going to be in the circuitry of the inducer assembly, meaning the pressure switches. It's sensing a flue problem, not proper draft in the flue, that sort of thing. So in both cases, we're talking about the safety controls turning it on and off. This is a safety issue. It's a safety issue. It's sensing or not sensing something that it should, or it's sensing that I'm sensing that there is a problem here. So both of these, if you've got a furnace doing that, it's time to call a technician.
This is a particular problem where there's not so many DIY fixes that we
this
we
is
hope
not
to
a
have.
That's a good way of putting it. This is something
it's kind of serious. Okay.
It's time to have it serviced. It's sensing that there is a problem and it's not going to go away. If you've caught it acting up once, it's going to do it again. When it does it again, it's going to be when you're wanting to use it.
Is short cycling, is that pretty much always when it's just immediately on then off, or can it also be happening when it just runs for like a few minutes and then it turns off?
Well, typically it's going to be that immediate on and off. If you're sensing that your furnace isn't going through a complete cycle, like say I've got it set on a temperature and I hear it cycling off before it reaches that temperature, those are some adjustments that can be made to the furnace. It's really kind of a communication problem between the thermostat and the furnace. Thermostats don't simply sense the room temperature as it is right now, because if that's the case, we would always be overshooting the room temperature and under, you know, if you think about it, if we had it set at 72, that means it's not going to turn off till it's 73 and it's not going to turn back on until it's 71. Well, that's a 2-3 degree spread that you're going to notice in the room. Thermostat and the controls have a way to anticipate what the temperature is going to be before it overshoots it.
The thermostat isn't as smart as I thought it was then. The thermostat just knew it was sensing exactly temperature in the room.
It's much smarter than you gave it credit for. You know, it's not just simply checking the room temperature, but it's anticipating what it ought to be.
Is a short cycling usually a problem? Like, what's the culprit?
Most of the things that are going on right now that we're talking about are maintenance related, meaning cleanliness and proper adjustment. It's not something super serious, but it takes an experienced technical hand to know exactly what's going on.
Okay, cool. Okay. Thanks,
Very
Dad.
Good.
Bye.
Okay, bye-bye.